we don't know. When that CHAMPS come, let them come find out whose disease where they kill them pikia.
Every day, approximately 15,000 children under the age of 5 die, according to a recent UNICEF study, with the majority of these deaths occurring in Sub-Saharan Africa and South Asia. Although strides have been made to reduce the under 5 mortality rate, the actual cause of death often remain a mystery due to little or no information regarding the health of the children before they died or their medical condition when they died. In the hours and days after the death of a child, many families experience deep feelings of hurt, anger, and confusion. With the lack of information regarding the cause of their child's death, parents sometimes blame themselves.
There's no name given to a mother who loses a child. If you lose a parent, you're called an orphan. If you lose a husband, you're called a widow. But there's no name for somebody who loses a child, because the pain is deep.
In low-income countries throughout the world, especially in the places where CHAMPS is working, children often die without being seen by trained medical personnel. They also die without a documented medical history and are often buried before a cause of death is known. The Child Health and Mortality Prevention Surveillance Network, also known as CHAMPS, is working to help prevent deaths in children under the age of 5 by obtaining, analyzing, and sharing more precise, accurate, and comprehensive information about the deaths of individual children. The purpose of CHAMPS is to better identify why individual children died so that preventable causes of those deaths that otherwise would remain unknown can be discovered. By doing this, CHAMPS can provide cause of death information that can inform recommendations, policies, and actions to improve child health. Currently, the CHAMPS network has sites in Bangladesh, Ethiopia, Kenya, Mali, Mozambique, Sierra Leone, and South Africa.
The information that we currently have is really broad and general and just doesn't accurately reveal the actual or contributing causes of deaths in children. Now, the CHAMPS project and all of the information it collects is really vital because it is focused on better ways to identify why a child died.
When a child under 5 dies in a CHAMPS network community, families are asked if they are willing for their child to undergo minimally invasive tissue sampling, or MITS. With MITS, the ability to identify the specific cause of death is greatly increased, especially if a pathogen like a virus or bacteria was involved. In addition to MITS data, CHAMPS collects information using verbal autopsy interviews and medical records to help determine the actual cause of death.
We've always known that the verbal autopsies produces it's useful results, but a fairly imperfect data. And being able to move away from that is to come up with more definitive cause of death that we can have our professional community, be able to bite into and say, okay, this is what is happening. We need to do something about those.
CHAMPS findings are also able to offer families information about what happened to their child. This data can be helpful in fighting stigma and discrimination against families that have lost a child in communities where cause of death information is lacking.
So we believe the cause of death information the CHAMPS network is collecting has great potential to save lives. With more and better information on what actually is causing the death of an infant or child, local hospitals, clinicians, and public health programs are better able to take actions to protect other infants and young children, and most importantly, to do that more quickly.
CHAMPS is now releasing, for the first time, cause of death information from CHAMPS sites. This is the beginning of an effort that addresses a critical knowledge gap. In the years ahead, addressing that gap should help prevent childhood deaths and illness in places where far too many children die before their 5th birthday.
CHAMPS will help us to make sure that our babies will celebrate their 5th year anniversary.